Chapter 6 How to Save Human Beings
第六章如何求度众生
Chapter 1 Why are they congratulating me on receiving the bow ladies and gentlemen? I would like to extend my heartiest congratulations to you for this is your most auspicious day.Today you have received the bow which is the ultimate aim of existence. All of the Buddhas and saints attained the bow in the past and, by transcending the limitations of birth and death, had become immortal. That which you have received today is the same bow. Formerly,One who intended to receive the bow had to abandon worldly possessions and enjoyments. If he was a king, he had to abandon his kingdom. If he was a high official, he had to resign his high position, leave his family and go to the remote mountains to seek a master who would transmit the Tao to him.After much suffering he would gradually perfect his conduct, purify his mind and heart and perform many good deeds. For his sincerity, God would send Buddha to transmit the Tao to him. Under such conditions a person able to succeed was hard to find.During that period the bow was secretly transmitted from one patriarch to another.
第一章为什么他们恭喜我求得天道各位先生太太小姐首先让我衷心地恭喜你们因为今天是你们大喜的日子今天你们得了道道是至宝，道超出了一切。每一位古圣先贤佛祖皆于古代求得天道，故他们能超出生死之界限而永存。今天你们所得的道即同他们其实所得的道一样。在古时人要得到必须弃他在世界上所拥有之一切与享受。假如他是一位皇帝，也必须弃他的江山。假如他是一位大，他必须舍弃他的爵，离开家人，入深山寻访能够指点他途径。传授大道给他的名师在他经历了千辛万苦之后同时已将凡心修炼成佛心并已达至圆满之行为以及做了许多善事在他至诚之下终于感动上天之心派仙佛来指点传授大道给他在如此之情况下成功者非常稀少在那时道是由一代祖师逆传给下一代祖师
Today we need not go to the remote mountains in order to cultivate ourselves We may find the means to do so in our own environmentTherefore we must take full advantage of our fortunate circumstances because we are in close proximity to the Tao. Why is the Tao so accessible to us at this time? It is because mankind is facing great calamities which signal the destruction of the human race.What is the cause of these calamities in this modern age? Most people blindly worship technical science and neglect spiritual harmony. They believe that the power of mankind can surpass nature and that science is almighty and can solve all human problems. It would seem as though conscience or soul are only religious terms and had no real existence. Most people do not recognize their true selves, which are indestructible and immortal. Actually, the true self is the master of the mortal body. Today most people have lost their consciences, harming others in order to benefit themselves. Those evils which human beings are now committing will cause great disasters the likes of which had never been witnessed before. This will be the final calamity in which the human race, the immortals of space, and the ghosts in hell will all be destroyed.
然而现在我们不需要到深山去，而我们一默修行，何以我们能如此容易就得到？这是因为时代不同了。现在人类面对劫难之来临，末劫就要来到，末劫将会毁灭全人类。劫难是怎样造成的？原因是在此新世纪，多数的人们共盲目崇拜科学，而不注重心灵的完善。他们相信人类的力量能超出大自然，科学是高于一切，科学是万能，科学能解一切人类之问题。而良心、灵性仅是宗教之名词，它永不能实现。人们不认识真理，真理是我们之良心、道心、真我本体，它不不灭，万不长存。它是主持我一生之主人翁。如今世上的众生大多数失去了真正的良心，他们造一切之罪恶，因此造成了空前绝后之浩劫，我们称它为末劫。在此浩劫中，不仅全世界的众生，同时起天的大仙、地府的鬼魂都要受劫灭。
However, GodOf whose essence we are created, is merciful and compassionate and does not desire that the good people be destroyed along with the evil ones. So God has provided that the Tao be disseminated among mankind and has sent the great teachers, Buddha Shikha and Bodhisattva Yui.To rescue the three kinds of beings, the immortals of space, human beings, and the ghosts in hell, so that they may return to heaven together. Buddha Shikha and Bodhisattva Yui are under the command of God and are responsible for transmitting the Tao to the three kinds of beings.Their duty is to manage the work called the last salvation. This salvation is formless and soundless, and the transmission is performed without preaching. It directly points out the original nature, conscience or soul of mankind in order that people may realize their true nature and thereby become enlightened.
然而是我们灵性的至高无上之母亲上帝是非常的慈悲，一不忍善恶俱焚，因此降下真道，并派名师济公活佛与月慧菩萨降世，挽救三曹弃天之大仙。世界的众生、地府的鬼魂同返天堂，我们师尊师母二位老大人奉老母的命令，真传真守，普度三曹， 他们的责任是办理幕后一收人大事，不立文字，教外别传，直指人心，直指人人不有之良心。灵性使人们见自性而成佛。
When the last calamity arrives, nothing can save mankind except the true way, which is the Tao sent from God. That is why the Tao is widely propagated today to save good people. Ancient people first cultivated themselves and then received the Tao. But today we receive the Tao first and then cultivate ourselves. Therefore, after we have received the Tao, we have to seriously cultivate ourselves. Then we shall automatically be safe from danger, escape from calamities, avoid reincarnation and become saints and Buddhas.
当末劫临头时，没有任何其他方法可以解救众生，除了上帝所降下的唯一之道。因此现在大道普渡善男信女，古人是先修后的，先修道然后才得道，现在我们是先的后修，因此得道以后，我们要真正修道，将来自然能逢凶化吉，堕劫彼难，超生了死，成圣成佛。
Although it is easier for modern people to receive the Tao than it was for past generations, the ability to receive the Tao also depends on each person's condition and background. Today you receive the Tao because you had an affinity with our temple and you and your ancestors have performed many virtuous acts. Possibly you were cultivated in a religion in your previous lives. These conditions allow you to have an affinity for the Tao. Without this affinity you would never receive it.
虽然今人比古人更易得道，然而亦是各凭各知根基缘分。今天你们得道皆因与佛有缘，前世有行善积德，祖先有德，也许前世有修过五大宗教或其他宗教，因此使你们今天有缘得道，否则将永不能得道。
Chapter 2 What is the Tao, ladies and gentlemen?You have received the Tao today, but what did you actually receive? What is the Tao? The Tao is the source of everything. Tao is the creator and master of the universe. Tao is God, the supreme power. Before the earth and sky existed, before the creation of the universe, the Tao existed.After the universe is annihilated and nothing remains, the Tao will continue to exist and to create and control a new universe. The Tao is limitless, invisible and formless. It cannot be seen, heard, smelled or touched and is beyond the power of human comprehension. Tao activates everything.Yet we cannot see its action. It works without effort, yet nothing left undone. Man usually calls it nature. Nothing can exist without the Tao because everything depends on it. Tao is God and our soul issues from God's essence. We are God's children.
第二章蛇魔是道，各位今天已经得到 究竟的是什么？什么是道？道是天地人万物之母，道是宇宙之本源，创造者地及主宰者，道上帝，道至尊至贵之神。当天地还未生之前，一切都未有之前，道已先存在的。当天地毁灭后，道不毁灭，道能再生天地人万物。天地人万物生成了，道其中主宰。道非常奥妙，道无形无相，视而不见，听而不闻，不可嗅，不可捉摸。道超出了人们的想象力而不思议，亦不可言说，一切皆是道所为。然而我见不到道的动作，道是无为而为的，然一切莫不是道所为。人们常称它为自然。假若无道，任何一物不能存在，因为一切都依靠道而的存。道上帝，我们之灵性是上帝所赐，我们是上帝之儿女，上帝是我们之天。
When we speak of the creator of the universe, we call it Tao. When we speak of the ruler of everything, we call it natural law. When we speak of the animating and controlling principle of our being, we call it soul or conscience. When we speak of the creator of our soul,We refer to the Heavenly Mother in Chinese, she is called Lao Mu. All I left the above are one and the same.
当我们从它作为宇宙之本源而言，称它为道。在它作为一切之主宰而言，我们称它为理。当它在我们体内，是我们生存定之配肉体时，我们称它为灵性或良心，因为它赋予我们本性。我们称它为老，这些名称虽异而其意相同，皆指同一物而言。
Now, what you have actually received is the Tao.Tao is everybody's true self. Today you have been initiated by the teacher and the door of your mind has been opened. Now you are able to understand that the body is not your true self. The body is controlled by the Tao within you.
现在你们得的就是道，道是每一个人的真我。今天你们以的名师指点开了心窍，现在你认识了肉体并非真正的你，而灵性才是真正的你，那位无形无相的。然而在支配你的身体的灵性才是真正的你自己。
While you are alive, your soul dwells within your body.As soon as the soul leaves your body, you are dead. Your soul is from God, but your physical body is from your parents. You already had the Tao within you yet did not realize it. Therefore, you have had to search for it and had now been fortunate enough to find a teacher who was able to transmit it to you.Previously you believed that the physical body was your true self and behaved accordingly. You were selfish, committing misdeeds, acts of violence, and overindulging in physical pleasures. This condition repeatedly led you into a reincarnation and endless sufferings. Now you understand that your true self is not your physical body but only use the body as a vehicle. You are not limited to this physical body. You are boundless. You are the master of the universe because you have God's essence within you. You are full of mercy and love because you share of God's spirit. Most people today have forgotten all these spiritual characteristics and do not know who they really are. Today you are regaining your conscience, your true self.
每个人活时，灵性在他体内，若灵性已离开，他立刻就死亡。灵性附于天，而肉体由父母而来。因此，事实上，我们已有道在身上，为何还要再寻求他，还要有点传师来传授？原因是我们已不认识他了。我们以为肉体真我，而不知他原是假，因此我们变得自私，做了许多错事与恶。为了持此色身，享受如此，使我们坠入轮回中，遭受无边痛苦。我们不知真正的我乃是灵性，而我们已不是仅限于此肉身。我们是无限的广大，我们是宇宙之主宰，因我们的灵性与老是一体。我们的本性充满了慈悲与爱心，因我们是老之分灵。然而现在人们都失去了这些品性，亦不知他究竟是谁。今天我们得到是的回真我良心。
Chapter 3. What are the three treasures? Today you have received the three treasures. A. The heavenly portal B. The divine mantra C. The symbolic seal A. The first treasure, the heavenly portal, the point where the teacher placed his finger upon your face during the ceremony is called the heavenly portal. It is the abode of your true self and can be described in different ways, such as, 1. Original nature. This is the true self, soul, or conscience which is eternal and indestructible. 2. The portal of birth and death. The heavenly portal is the door by which our original nature enters and leaves our body. Confucius asked, who can leave the house without using the door? Why do people not follow this way? 3. The way to heaven. A Buddhist sutra says, heaven is 108,000 miles away. These words are the metaphor which actually means that it was not easy to become enlightened because the true teacher was difficult to find and the Tao was not yet widely propagated. Without the proper understanding of the Tao, heaven seems very far away, but with a real understanding of the Tao, heaven is very near. Today your teacher has pointed out the way for you and you may now ascend to heaven with one step.
第三章，何谓三宝经？天，你们所得之至宝亦可称为三宝：一玄关，二口诀，三合同。一第一宝玄关，玄关玄妙莫测之门。玄关点传师向你们指点之处， 它有许多名称，一点本性，此是我本来固有的真我灵性良心。它是不毁不灭的，它永远存在。二点，生死之门户玄关是灵性出入身体之门户。孔子曰，谁能出不由户，和莫由斯道也。三点，通天大陆，佛经云，西天十万八千里，此是譬喻，亦成佛是不义之事，因为名师难访，大道还未普传。然而名师经已指点明明路，你一步登天。四点，
The main entrance, the heavenly portal is the main entrance. It is situated at the center and not to the left or right, above or below. This entrance was locked after your imperishable spirit entered the body at birth. If the heavenly portal is not unlocked by your teacher,your true self is not able to leave the body by the main entrance at the time of death. Instead, it will have to leave by one of the side gates, A. The eyes, B. The ears, C. The mouth, D. The nose, E. The navel, F.The vertex. If your spirit leaves from the ears, it is reborn as a viviparous animal, such as a horse, pig, cow, sheep, etc. The eyes, it is reborn as an oviparous bird. See mouth, it is reborn as a creature of the water, such as a fish, a lobster, etc. The nose, it is reborn as an insect, such as a fly, a moth, a bee,etc. E. Navel, it is reborn as an ordinary person. F. Vertex, it is reborn as a wealthy and powerful person. 4.
正门玄关是正门，它正好位于当中，不偏向左也不偏向右，不在上也不在下。当灵性投入身体后，四门关闭了。假如我们不遇名师指开玄关，临终时我们的灵性将无正门可出离身体，它只能由其他旁门出去，眼耳口鼻入其顶门。如果灵性走旁门，亦由耳而出者，来生当为胎生之动物，如马、猪、牛、羊之类。二，由眼而出者，来生当为卵生之动物，如飞鸟之类。三，由口而出者，来生当为食生之动物，如鱼虾之类。四，由鼻而出者，来生当为化生之动物，如苍蝇、蜜蜂之类。五，由肚脐而出者，来生当为平庸之人。六，由顶门而出者，来生当为富贵之人。上述之路乃生死轮回之路，不能脱出生死之苦。点传师点开玄关正门，这是通天之路，我们不必再走四门，不必再坠入轮回受苦。但是我们必须要真修，否则玄关虽开，我们的灵性仍不能返天，因我们还是充满罪恶，灵性为罪恶所是不能自由从正门而出的。五点，
In the Bible, Matthew 13:11, John said to his disciples, I baptize you with water to show that you have repented, but that one who will come after me will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. The Tao is transmitted to you in the temple of God through God's sanction and commandment. The holy lamp on the altar symbolizes God. In the transmittal ritual, the teacher uses the incense to lead a line of fire from the holy lamp to your heavenly portal. Then, using his finger, he connects God's spirit with your spirit so that they flow together as one, thereby enlightening you with God's spirit. This is the actual fulfillment of John's prophecy. 5.
圣经上记载约翰对他的门徒说：“我用水给你们施洗，表明你们已悔改。然而在我之后的将用圣灵与火给你们施洗。请记忆，你们是在上帝的宫殿里得到，因为我们有上帝的天命。” 那盏佛灯代表上帝老，在点道之仪式中，你们已见到点传师以相助从佛灯引来一条经指向你们的玄关，然后借点传师的手指点在你们的玄关之时。 上帝一一地圣灵已点开了你们的心窍，照破了黑暗。现在你们可见到约翰之预言已经实现在你们身上。6.
I had the great dharma which is hidden in the eyes. This indicates the location of the heavenly portal.
6.
Read the second treasure, the Divine Mantra 1. You have now been given the Divine Mantra. It is very important to remember it as it will save your life. It is only to be used in extremely dangerous situations. This mantra acts as a powerful spiritual distress signal to the divine forces, much like an SOS transmitted by radio waves. It is to be projected mentally and silently with great concentration while at the same time focusing the eyes on the heavenly portal and holding the symbolic seal with the hands. Powerful aid will immediately be sent to you in order to rescue you from danger. If you sincerely cultivate yourself, you will always remain under the refuge of Buddha.
2. 第二宝口诀，心经或五字真经，一刚才传授口诀给你们，还记得吗？请再说一遍。当性命危险时，你才用此宝。